Hi everyone, this is Yann Camus of Bliss Climbing and Bliss Climbing Tech. Today I'm making a follow-up video on the Edelrid Fuse with the Bliss Climbing Tech Fuse Jammer used as a lead rope solo backup system. I came up with a solution if you don't have the Fuse Jammer kit, and after that setup I will show you some tests that I've done. Let's go! Hopefully soon I will be able to tell you that the Fuse Jammer kit is in production. Until then, you can use that micro traction system. I bought an Edelrid Defuser. This is the small, this is the long one. I'll use the short one right now. So you see, this is a Velcro zip tie, and I pass the Velcro right underneath the Defuser S, and I wrap the Velcro a little bit around my waist here. So it's 1 foot of Velcro zip tie. And now I will just attach this Defuser to a carabiner here. I will pick Edelrid slider lock. It's very useful because it's a locker, but very simple. It is a secondary attachment to the rope. I think it's much better, much safer. In order to use the Petzl Micro Traxion instead of the Fuse Jammer, you will need a small cord paracord, the 550. I will pass it through the arm. I pass it on each side here. So you will say this is a strange way to pass it. I will make one side a little bit longer, square knot, as tight as possible. And I pass the two ends inside the arms holes on each side like this. I attach my system. Like this. Okay, and let's pretend this is my lead rope. I can push everything through, but I show you how to open the devices and pass the rope. I pass the micro traction with the holding cam at the top there. Close this, and I attach the micro traction with my small cord with a square knot. This is what I want to do. As tight as possible on the side here. I should have a little bit more cord. That would make it easier. I need my cord to be really steady, and you might find another way to attach it more securely maybe. Guess what? This is it. This is what we want. It holds the rope down there, and then you can take some rope back. If I need to reverse the rope in the micro traction, I can press the button and hold the cam open, and I can pull it open. If you're into the weeds, this mode right there that I can pull down will be useful in a top rope solo part at the beginning of a sport route with two inline bolts used as the bottom belay anchor. So you would be safer, and when you get to climb on actual lead, you just push the micro traction cam in place and then start feeding your cache loop, and then you have your backup device. The Fuse Jammer will be a game changer. It will be smaller than the micro traction, all integrated in the Edelrid Fuse. Today I'm testing the Fuse with a Grigri, and I have also a SuluGo because they're different devices, and I think using the Edelrid Fuse as a backup for lead rope solo will be different with these two devices. I'll tell you why. Today I'm basically proving the concept, so I will be pretending that the primary device fails and just see what happens. Let's go. So I noticed that the most slippery ropes that could be a problem because you want a backup to grab correctly, and the Edelrid Fuse is made for ropes 10 millimeter and more, and low stretch ropes. I found that the worst situation is an Edelrid Fuse that was used with a very brand new slippery dynamic rope of thin diameter. The closest I have to that case is a 9.2 millimeter by Sterling, dry treated, so very slick. I put my 82 kilos and now it does not slide. I will change location on the rope. Not sliding. Put my weight. If I push myself down, it slips. Probably 100 kilograms is what's needed here. I will try my 9.4 Sterling rope. Trying to make it slip. Yeah, it's not slipping. If I push myself down, it slips. Yeah, so it needs like 90 kilograms to slide on that rope. So you get the topo. Someone tried a brand new Joker by Beal, 9.1 millimeter, and it was just about the same. I will need to put my hands on a piece of rope, opera, whatever length, brand new. Send it to me, guys. I want to test it. I have an old one. It's not slipping. Okay, and now I will try the backup system. So I put the Grigri the reverse way. It's a Grigri 2, this one. Did I put it wrong? No, I put it right. Okay, now it slips. It slips fully. Attach it. I will attach the top, the chest harness, like this. So now it's like I'm pretending held upright position using the Bliss Climbing Tech GG modifier, the best device to change your Grigri to suspend it on the chest rig. I will put my backup, the fuse, like this. I will open the device, put the rope in there. I will take the slack like this. So it's slack in between the fuse and the Grigri that's held upright and wrongly loaded. So now I'm loading. The Grigri is not holding. Fuse is already catching. Now I will take some rope back for demo. And I put my weight on it. Now the Edelrid fuse is almost at the Grigri. Okay, so the Velcro released. The fuse just smashes into the Grigri. It's not ideal, but it shouldn't make it fail at all because the cam is on the other side. It cannot be a problem. I will take the slack back so I'm higher in the frame. So the question is the holding power of 80 kilos enough to stop your fall with the friction inside the Grigri? Well, I think obviously yes. I will put my weight on the system, try to push myself down. It holds very steady and it's not slipping at all. Right now it's a kind of a third hand, so it doesn't have to hold my full weight. And that's good. So now I will do a new test. I will put the Grigri in the correct manner, but I will attach it wrong to my harness. Instead of going like this, held upright, I will do like this. So what will happen is that it will be just like I'm doing an upside down fall, but I'm not. Small carabiner to hold the Grigri like this. Pretend it's held upright. Edelrid fuse. All right. And now I engage the cam. What I think will happen is the cord holding the Grigri upright will break and I will fall on the Grigri as normal. I can't put all my weight because it will break the cord of the GG mod. I push the Edelrid fuse as high as I can and I do the simulation of, so now I'm upside down falling. I see the Grigri is holding because there's some tension from the backup already. Boom, I put my weight. So Velcro undid, the Edelrid Fuse jammed into the Grigri. I continue to load. So now it's slipping, but okay, so now the cord of the GG modifier broke. So the GG modifier is intact. I can replace the cord in the field. And now the Grigri is holding me just like normal with a little bit of help from the Edelrid Fuse. A little bit under my body weight, the cord of the GG modifier broke. It's here, clean cut. Don't do that every day because it will litter the environment, but you do what you gotta do to do your climb. Try to find it back, put it in the trash. You need a cord like this to replace. They come with the GG modifier. I carry a spare one on my harness. Nice knot there. So now it's good. I'm ready to do another try. I will do the exact same thing. My Edelrid Fuse backup with the fuse jammer kit. Again, upside down, it's mounted wrong. So to pretend I'm doing an upside down fall, and I will now fall a little bit. I will lock the backup fuse like this, and yeah, a little bit of slack there. I don't think there will be a problem, and I'm ready to commit my life to that system. I'm a little bit scared. So, 1, 2, 3. So, it went super fast. There was the backup. It was already engaged. It triggered the Grigri a little bit. You see that the rope is on the handle. That's weird. It should never happen with a Grigri 2. I don't have my triangle flap cut. It's unnerving, so it's good that you have a backup at least. And it broke the GG modifier cord. Now there was a lot more energy going into it, like it exploded at the knot. Wow, that's crazy. The GG modifier, first time I really jump breaking it, I think. It's in perfect condition. I can take a new cord, no problem. So GG modifier still working fine. And all it did is trigger the Grigri and boom, saved my life. So I can push the rope back on correctly, undo my backup. Okay, Edelrid Fuse, and I can rappel down. Very good testing. And now I will do the SuluGo. Same exact thing. Instead of putting right side up, I put it upside down to pretend I do an upside down fall. It will be very close to my face. I have a small modification on it to make it suspended like this for lead rope solo. This is how it should be. Okay, like this. So now it slides because I'm pretending it's upside down. So crazy stuff right there. I will directly jump on it because I don't recommend you do that at home. Test slowly. So I hoist myself a little bit. Now I'm high enough, I take the slack, I put the Edelrid Fuse backup with the Velcro. I will put even a backup knot here, so it will break the cord that's holding upright the SuluGo. And then right now you see SuluGo is not doing anything because it will just slide down. In the Grigri, the rope goes around in the device, but here it's straight up, so that's why I'm testing it. It's very different. So I'm ready to jump, clip myself, okay, and I jump. It broke the cord exactly as I expected, and it ripped the Velcro holding the Edelrid fuse. Now the fuse is loaded, the SuluGo is engaged, and it saved my butt from hitting the ground. That's very good. The cord is right there. It didn't explode like it did on the GG modifier. Reason for that is that this cord was passing inside some metal, and the metal cut much more than the GG modifier that is nice and smooth to the cord. Proof of concept is done right now. It activated the SuluGo, broke the system holding it to the chest, and so now even if the Edelrid fuse slips a little bit, is the SuluGo that will save my life, my primary lead rope solo device. Does that make sense? I hope it does. I hope you like this video. Push on the like button, go see my websites, Bliss Climbing for online courses and Bliss Climbing Tech for gear. Register to our mailing list to get all the news when the fuse jammer comes into production. Thank you.